Good afternoon, everybody. It's December the 3rd, 2014, and I haven't put up a video on Bill Bing's Trumpet Talk for some time, but I was inspired last night when I saw a video with James Morrison, the great trumpet artist, soloist, who also plays amazingly beautiful on the trombone and keyboard. He's just a brilliant musician. And what he talked about in one of his videos, he has a series of videos that are great, and if you learn nothing else from this video, go check out his videos on YouTube and his trumpet website as well. I think it's jamesmorrison.com. And in any case, he talks about when you want to play high notes, this is his high note video, what you have to learn how to do, in most cases, if you're not doing it already, is to use less pressure as you play high. The natural tendency is to use more pressure. And that's why so many of us have trouble in the upper register, right? The first thing that happens is the sound will cut out when we use too much pressure, or our endurance will suffer. And so one of the things he says, you've got to learn to use less pressure when you play. And one of the ways in which I have learned to use less pressure is from quite a long time ago, I came up with a series of exercises to do just that. It's from the Bing book. It's available free on my website, williambing.com. I think it's lesson 13, number is 1, 2, and 3, something like that. But what you do is you play first with a normal pressure embouchure, and then the second time you'll repeat it with getting a half buzz and a half playing kind of a sound so that you're using less pressure. And you want to get some trumpet sound through the bell, but you also want to get some kind of a buzzing sound. So it's a combination of a buzzing sound and a trumpet sound. And then the third time, you'll go back to doing it on a more regular way. You can do this on any exercise or piece of music, really. But the whole idea is to do something with that sound in mind. And so the first time through would be, and then the second time would be that half buzzing, half playing sound. And the third time is back to the regular sound. And you can do it on a lower note or a higher note if you want as well. So this is just one approach to developing an embouchure where you don't have to depend on pressure, but you can depend on the air. I'll try to put up some more kinds of exercises and thoughts along those lines. But in any case, I wanted to put this up because I thought it might be helpful. Well, take care and keep blowing. Bye-bye. Hello. I would like to add to that video. In James Morrison's teaching video, he mentions that you should be prepared to lose a little bit of range when you start using less pressure. And indeed, that is more than likely to be the case, but many professionals can't afford to do that. So what I usually recommend doing is devoting at least maybe 10 minutes of your routine to this kind of practice. You can do that easily. You're not going to mess up your chops at all. And eventually you'll find that you play more and more correctly as time goes along, and you'll be able to devote more and more time to this kind of practice because you're building up the muscles to play correctly as opposed to practicing incorrectly. Just thought I'd better add that. Thanks. Bye-bye.